Today we continue with more super interesting use cases on the FinCrime Agent GPT. If you missed all the videos, this AI tool was fine-tuned for people like you working in the broader financial crime prevention and regulatory compliance industry to help you with a huge list of activities. So in this video, I will explain more in details what you can do with FinCrime Agent GPT by performing a GPTS demo with a practical example where I'm uploading a handwritten complex company structure to test if our FinCrime Agent GPT is able to identify who is the ultimate beneficial owner. So another very exciting episode is going to start, so let's jump right into today's video. For those of you who didn't see yet the FinCrime Agent GPT, let me quickly introduce you to this great AI tool before we start with the GTPS demo. FinCrime Agent GPT is fine-tuned for assisting you with a broad range of AML financial crime and regulatory compliance tasks. So the solution is accessible by anyone with a ChatGPT Plus account, and it can support multiple languages, so helping users to navigate compliance scenarios, for example, analyze use cases, and of course, staying also updated with regulations, including those specific to blockchain and cryptocurrency. So this is a great asset to have for a broad audience, including compliance officers, auditors, law enforcement, and also educational institutions. So let's explore in today's GPTS demo another use case on how this tool is the best friend of anyone that is involved in the fight against financial crime. I uploaded a sketchy company structure here where we have a number of parent and child companies, each owning different stake of the company. So there is also a private individual as part of this complex company structure. And my aim is to get some help from FinCrime Agent GPT in establishing who is the actual ultimate beneficial owner of company C. Okay, this is the first action that I took. I've already taken a picture with my phone of this scribble, and now I'm uploading the image file into FinCrime Agent GPT in JPEG format, showing a company structure, and I'm asking, can you please help me establish the ultimate beneficial owner of company C? As we can see, FinCrime Agent GPT firstly provided me with a recap of company structure to validate that all percentages in my scribble are correct, and yes, they are. Then it started to explain the controlling stakes across all entities. In our prompt, we didn't actually specify in which jurisdiction we are based, so FinCrime Agent GPT now is providing to us a broad definition of UBO by applying the 25% rule. Here we can see the explanation and rationale used to establish who is the UBO of company C. So I think this is already very impressive, but let's complicate things even further. I'm now making company A owned by multiple shareholders, where each of those own no more than 5% of company A. Let's see how it goes. As you can see, even with this variation, which would probably put on the spot quite a few of well-experienced AML and KYC investigators, so the revised FinCrime Agent GPT explanation is again correct and provides a quick and useful perspective for the identification of the UBO of this fictitious company C. So there are many more applications of this tool. As I mentioned before, you can write in any language and it can guide you through any use cases or compliance-related scenarios. It can work on case studies for you or with you, of course, update you on the latest regulations based when where you are around the world. So please let me know in the comments of this video what you think of it, and if you would like to see even more GPTS demo with use cases on my FinCrime Agent GPT. And I hope today's demo was useful. Don't forget to subscribe and to support my FinCrime Agent project. My Patreon link, you will find it in the video description. So you can also send a super thanks directly from this YouTube video if you wish. That's all for today. Thank you for watching, and until next time, see you soon.